Hey, my name is Arije. I'm a dyslexic in the field of education studies, and in this video I would like to talk to you about the Kobi app. It's an app with which dyslexics are able to read with greater ease. I'm a fan of upfront conclusions, so I would like to tell you that I do like the app and that I do recommend it, even though I believe that you could probably get away with not spending any money on the app, but instead adopting the strategies that it uses. It would be a lot more effort though. I talked to the founders of Kobi and they told me why they started Kobi in the first place. We're gonna start the video with that chapter. And after, I'm gonna go into the different functions that Kobi offers and explain them.
When our daughter started going to school, you know, it's like this typical story when you have a healthy, happy child that goes to school, and then on your first parent and child meeting, the teacher says to you, well, you know, when she climbs under the table, then I just let her be, and then she comes out after a while. And I was like, what do you mean she climbs under the table? You know, it was like, and then you figure out the whole thing that, like, there is an issue there, and that all the other consequences that are coming with it. So insecurity within the school environment and everything. So because we were in Slovenia at the time already and there was no systematic approach in handling this, I just, you know, self-learned what I needed to learn. And I was working with her very systematically and she progressed well. And yeah, and along the way, we discovered a few tricks that really worked very well. And one of them was this coloring of the letters. Because obviously, since we are designers, we are using this type of tools in order to, you know, work. And we were inventing a lot of like little games and God knows what. Mm-hmm. And then we were thinking, wow, this is really, you know, fantastic. Why wouldn't we try to digitalize this? And so that the project Kobi started.
It's genetic, right? So who of you has it too?
Most likely, yeah.
I mean, he has dyscalculia. Things
it's
like
officially recognized by our accountant.
So I had a lot of fun talking to them, and now you also have an impression of the people behind Kobi. So now let's dive into the app, and I'm going to show you some of the settings. So if we go over here, we can go on the text editing settings, and there you can decide how big the text is supposed to be. You can also select the distance between the individual lines. And we also have the option to change the background color of the page. You might ask the question about which of these options are best or most optimal. Well, I found two different studies. This is one of them, and here they looked at the different font sizes and the line spacings. What they found was that comprehension questions had significantly more correct responses from font size 18 to 26. And for the line spacing, they found marginal effects suggesting that the two tested extremes, 0.8 and 1.8, impaired readability. This is the second study that I found, and here they looked at different background colors. So they found that peach, orange, and yellow significantly improve reading performance over cooler background colors, blue, blue-gray, and green. In terms of settings, this means that I would stay clear of the extreme ends of the line spacing options. So for example, I wouldn't use 1.0 and also not 1.8. And when it comes to the background color, I would avoid the bluish range of colors as well as the green ones. Next up, I would like to talk about color coding. And in order to access that, we're going to go over here. And this is especially useful if your child, for example, confuses letters with B and D. So what you can do is you can have these two light up in different colors, and that makes it easier for them to recognize it. And then it's less likely that they confuse the two. Another option to decrease complexity of words is to display consonants and vowels differently. So that is done with this option here. And this whole color coding idea goes back to Maria Montessori. So it's a quite established method to use. Next, I would like to talk about the progress tracking function. And in order to access it, you're going to go over here. You're going to go to the smiley. You tap on the screen, and then the app shows you how many words you read and how long you spent reading. You also have a similar page for the week, and you have all times. And there you can see how many readings you did in total and how many books there are in the app currently. The cool thing about this is that you're compared to yourself and your progress and not to your classmates. And that can make a lot of sense, especially for dyslexics. I asked Ursula and Auke about this function, and they told me about the feedback they got. And this is what they said.
So, because one of the really like heartwarming feedbacks we got from teachers was, one teacher once told me, I was reading with this boy and he was really struggling and he was like 13 and we were reading with Kobi. And then he said, okay, she asked him at the end of the session, so how many words do you think you read? And he was like, I don't know, maybe 50. And then they pressed our marker and it was like 500 words. And he was like, you should have seen the look on his face. Because completely exceeded his own expectation.
The last function that I would like to show you is the reading assistant. And to access that, we're going to go over here and we're going to go to reading assistant. And now you can slide over the text. And what this does, it's basically finger reading on steroids. And the reason why this works is because your eyes are attracted to motion. So I believe by now you got a good impression of what the app has to offer. If you still decide not to get the app, then I do suggest that you try out some of the strategies that it uses. For example, increase the font size to 18 or bigger. Make sure yet you use a background color that is friendly to the eye. If your child confuses B and D or other letters, you can color code them and make it easier that way. And encourage your child to finger read. Okay, I hope this helped and see you in the next video.